Now, we know a bunch about how you might encode information into your visualization and how to make an effective visualization, but we still haven't yet discussed how you can make graphics like this, short of drawing them with pen and paper. There are a number of packages for plotting in Python. One of the most popular is matplotlib. For this course, however, I'd like to go over plotting using a Python library called ggplot, which very closely recreates the syntax used in R's ggplot2 library. If matplotlib is so widely used, why should we use ggplot? Well, I'd like to use this package for a few reasons. First, what it produces is a bit more aesthetically pleasing than matplotlib. Second, it's an implementation of a pretty neat concept called the grammar of graphics, which basically claims that there's a grammar involved in composing graphical components of statistical graphics. The gg in ggplot actually comes from grammar of graphics. It also plays nicely with the pandas data frames we've been using in this course. To quickly summarize the ideas behind the grammar of graphics, plots convey information through their aesthetics, such as x position or y position. The elements in a given plot are geometric shapes, such as points, lines, or bars. Some of these shapes can have aesthetics of their own, such as their size or their color. You can think of creating plots in ggplot through the grammar of graphics as adding layers to our plot. The first step in creating a graphic is always to create our plot, which is essentially going to be our canvas. This can be done by calling ggplot data AES xvar yvar. Data here is going to be a pandas data frame, and xvar and yvar are going to be columns in that data frame. So what we're doing here is saying, let's make a ggplot. The data source is going to be our data frame, and the quantities that we're interested in plotting are xvar and yvar. This might be district and number of Aadhaar enrollments, or position and number of players, something like that. So what we've done here is we've made our ggplot. We've said that the data source that it will use is pandas data frame, and that the variables that we'll look at are xvar and yvar. This might be district and number of Aadhaar enrolled if we were using our Aadhaar data, or team and total number of players if we were using our baseball data, something like that. Okay, so far that we've said that we'll have a plot which is mapping xvar to the x-axis, yvar to the y-axis, but we haven't said yet what type of geometric object is going to represent this data. So if we add plus geom point to this statement, we'll create a scatter plot. If we also add plus geom line to the graphic, we'll connect all of these points to each other with lines. Now, say that we wanted these points to have a particular color. We can pass color equals coral into geom point, and also pass color equals coral into geom line. And after we do that, both the points and the lines will have the color coral. This is the second step of making a plot in ggplot. That is, choosing which type of geometric objects will represent the data. The final step here is going to be adding some labels so that our plot will have some context, like a title or an X label or a Y label. This can be done much in the same way that we added the points and lines to our plot. We can add a gg title to title our plot, an X lab, which will be X label, to provide an X label, and a Y lab to do the same with the Y axis. Now all I have to do is precede this entire command by print, and I'll produce a plot in Python. Why don't you try implementing these ideas to create a graphic of your own?